please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Very good morning. You're watching Trading Hour on CNBC TV18. I'm Ekta Batra. With me is Prashant Nair. And we've started the week definitely on the back foot for both for the Nifty, the Sensex, as well as for the Midcap Index. So currently, we're just at around 10,161.9. And that, in fact, is testing the 200-day moving average for the Nifty. In fact, right at that level at this point. So we have been testing it. Let's see whether we manage to decisively break through that level or not. It'll be a key technical level to watch. But otherwise, it is also the mid-caps which are underperforming in today's trade. So we're down around 1.3% currently for the mid-cap index and have a weak advance decline ratio on our hands as well. Lot of stocks in focus, HUL, Ashoka Buildcon, Shilpa Medicare, all of these stocks buzzing, and not to mention the oil marketing companies as well. Hi, Prashant.
Ekta, hi. I mean, as you said, back foot, and actually, frankly, disappointing because Friday the market sold off pretty, severely. The reason that, I mean, I could garner talking to people is maybe it was the FTSE rebalance impact. I mean, we highlighted that Friday morning, but it, largely in terms of focus, went sort of under the radar. But it was very chunky. Recalibration which happened because of the FTSE rebalance, and that may have been responsible, but that was Friday. What happened today? And I think that is essentially we have to ask ourselves, and that's why I'm saying this is disappointing. We've got news at the bottom of the screen, and this is also maybe one more, I mean, not a worry, but it doesn't help. No confidence motion against the NDA government moved by the YSR Congress and TDP in Parliament. So that is what is coming through. Lok Sabha has been adjourned till noon. I mean, I think almost simultaneously, you need the Parliament to function for anything to be taken up. And what we've seen is since the 5th of this month, when Parliament reconvened, we've not had any business conducted essentially because of, I mean, no decorum in the House, and today is no different. Even this, I mean, a no confidence motion can be taken up only if there is some semblance of order in the House, and I think that is what the Lok Sabha Speaker on Friday had indicated as well. So for now, the motion has been moved, but I guess it can't be taken up. The House has been adjourned till noon. That's what we are coming out with. I mean, I don't think anybody seriously expects this to do anything to the government. I mean, the government, the BJP plus allies are sitting very, very comfortably. So there is, nothing to worry about politically in that sense for the market. But we'll see, I mean, how this one goes at the end of the day. Sudarshan Sukhani of S2Analytics.com is now joining in for a quick chat on the market. Sudarshan, good morning. Good to have you here. Your sense of things now this Monday morning?
Good morning. Well, we are in some kind of a downtrend since Thursday, and we are short at 10,350. That short position should be maintained. Slowly, it does appear that the market is heading towards 10,000. Not necessarily today, but slowly. So the trade today is to keep your put position, bearish positions by using puts, put options, and add to your bearish positions on any 30 or 40 point rally. So this is a sell on a rally market for today and for the next few days.
Okay, morning Sudarshan. Stocks?
Well then, regrettably today it's really selling all over. Capital First is a short sell. Most financial NBFCs had small rallies. Those small rallies have fizzled out and new declines are now in the offing. Same for Capital First. Then we have NMDC, where that small mini bear trend is already on. It's come down from 145 to 125, and that decline shows no signs of ending. That's a short sell. And finally, Torrent Power. All power companies are in some kind of a bear market, mini bear market of their own. Short selling should be done intraday, but the trend is for lower levels in the Nifty itself.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so all around selling, 35 off on the Nifty, you've got a 90 off on the Bank Nifty. Mid-cap index, of course, is faring far worse. It's down 1.33%, that's about 260 points. We've got some questions from viewers. Karthik has 100 shares of Avenue Supermarts. He's paid 913 rupees each for them. He wants to know whether he should hold or sell. Sudarshan, Avenue.
Well, I think he should hold on to it. Don't look at the price now. Think of the price 3 years hence, and it will be much higher. So stay on with it. Accept the volatility and stick to your share. Hold on.
Okay. All right. Fair enough, Sudarshan. We're going to let you go on that note. Thanks very much for joining in and taking us through all of those strategies. We've got some more calls. Rahul Shah of Motilal Oswal is here to share his F&O calls with us. Rahul, hi. Morning. Over to you then. Stocks as well as index?
I think what we have seen is the sell-off continued since last few sessions. And I think in this series also, we've seen the continuous sell on rise kind of series. So my sense is, I think that the sectors which are in flavor, I think they are showing some sign of weakness and some unwinding happening in those sectors. So like, for example, metals, I think, had been a star for quite some time. And now, last few sessions, we have seen some unwinding happening. And I think a weakness is continued in that. Obviously, secondly, is the banking, which was a party spoiler in Feb, and I think which has continued this month as well. So I think private sector banks, the large private sector banks, which was strong, again, there we are seeing some unwinding happening. So I think these two sectors remains the weak. So I think the best thing is to short the weak among them. So I think from the metal space, I've identified Hindalco. So I think I believe that Hindalco one should short from the current levels with a stop loss of 226 and target of 205. Second is HDFC Limited. We've seen NBFC also, again, as I said, financials cracking down. So I think HDFC Limited looks weak for a short. So I think one can short HDFC Limited with a stop loss of 1830 and target of 1740. And one buy, I think, from that space is, from the entire market is the pharma space is Ajanta Pharma. So I feel that that stock has been done quite well vis-a-vis the other pharma stocks. And I think it's showing good sign. So one can go long on Ajanta Pharma with a stop loss of 1380 and target of 1460.
All right, Rahul, thanks very much. Appreciate you joining us with those trades, two sells, one buy. Just put up Jayaprakash Associates. I mean, it came up at the bottom of your screen as an alert. It's selling off. And this, 2 days after we had a prominent investor picking up a significant amount of stock in the company. Stock's at about 1980. It's recovering. It was down 6.5%. And of course, the metal index, the Nifty metal index, should come up next. It's down a full 2.25%. And it's a top loser, by the way, across the board. 3583. Rahul was mentioning how that space looks very weak. He's got a sell in that space as well. I mean, the next biggest loser of any size is the PSU Bank index, which is down 1.5%, 2886 on the Nifty PSU Bank index. Okay, over the weekend, a host of important political, economic, and sports and entertainment leaders gathered at Network 18's Rising India Summit. The highlight was the Prime Minister's 45-minute speech. Here are some excerpts.
भारत ने अपने साथ ही पूरी दुनिया की इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ को मजबूती दी है, जो देश वर्ल्ड जीडीपी का केवल 3% हिस्सा है, वो आज वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमी की ग्रोथ में 7 गुना ज्यादा कंट्रीब्यूट कर रहा है। जितने भी मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक पैरामीटर हैं, इन्फ्लेशन, करंट अकाउंट डेफिसिट, फिस्कल डेफिसिट, जीडीपी ग्रोथ, इंटरेस्ट रेट, एफडीआई इनफ्लो, भारत सभी में आज अच्छा परफॉर्म कर रहा है। आज विश्व में भारत के संदर्भ में जो बातें होती हैं वो आशा और विश्वास के साथ होती है, पूरे भरोसे के साथ होती है। यही वजह है कि तमाम रेटिंग एजेंसियां भारत की रेटिंग में सुधार कर रही हैं। आज दुनिया की टॉप 3 प्रोस्पेक्टिव होस्ट इकोनॉमीज में भारत का नाम लिया जाता है। वर्ल्ड बैंक की ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस की रैंकिंग में भी हमने सिर्फ 3 साल में 42 अंकों का सुधार किया है।
I mean, the market's down 35 points on the Nifty, but I'm looking at about 100 single stock futures. And, there is one name which is up over 1%. I mean, that's the extent of general weakness in the market. That's PC Jewelers, which is up about 1.25%. I'm talking about single stock futures. In terms of large losers, there is SAIL, Steel Authority of India. All March futures almost 7% lower. REC is down about 4.25% lower. OBC, that is Oriental Bank of Commerce, again something like 4.5%. Syndicate Bank is down another 4%. Tata Global, which has been relatively strong all these days, is down 4%. I think there's a downgrade from Deutsche Bank on Tata Global. And then there is Mindtree, Bank of Baroda, BPCL, IOC, NIIT Tech, all between 3.5% and 4% down. So this is pretty widespread, even though the Nifty is just showing about 30-34 points cut at this point. Let's also look at what's happening in the commodities space. And I think, as I was talking about before we took that break, metals are the top losing sector in the market right now. And Manisha is here to talk about that and more. Manisha, morning.
Hi, morning, and thank you so much for that, Prashant. Well, yes, this is a sector which has seen considerable decline come in. If Friday was anything to go by, you are looking at further follow-through selling in precious metals and in the industrial metals as well. So you have the gold and silver prices trading at a one-month low. You have the steel and the iron ore prices trading at a four-month lows as well. This has to do with the strength in U.S. dollar. You have the U.S. Fed meeting that kickstarts tomorrow. While there is, of course, an expectation of a 25 basis interest rate hike, it also is about the guidance on the inflation, jobs, and how the monetary policy will move further in 2018. That really seems to be pulling all of those prices on the weaker side. Add to that the concerns of the U.S. import tariff war, and markets also are looking at data coming in today in the evening. You have the U.S. construction and the home sales numbers. It also is the manufacturing number from Eurozone that markets would take cues from. Vati Gnansekar now joins us to talk more about that. Gnansekar, hi, good to have you. What is your sense, first of all, on the gold prices? Because the net long positions are at a 2018 lows. So that really means that there are less people now, you know, betting on the bullishness on gold prices going forward.
Compared to the beginning of the year, yes, it seems so, Manisha. But in a slightly bigger and a macro picture, there are so many tailwinds for gold, but somehow it's not finding the kind of follow through. So I guess it's just biding its time, clearly. And, the potential rate hikes is something which is a big gap. But we have seen historically that, whenever these rate hikes have happened, not only in the last five to six years, even much before, is that, gold tends to do very well in an inflationary environment like what it is right now. So on a longer picture, I'm still very optimistic on gold prices. But, you could see near-term volatility, which could pressure prices in the near term. But I think I'll use that as a wonderful long-term opportunity to be on the long side.
Okay. How would you talk about the metals then? Because there, of course, are concerns in the global markets. The China output could be coming back as winter eases. And it is about the construction demand for the second quarter as well, which is strong, a seasonal quarter in the year for that sense. Are you picking up anything right now with the kind of declines we have seen?
I think in the current decline, there is still some scope for prices to go down. There doesn't seem like, at least on the technical side, there is no indication that, we are anywhere near a bottom, which means that any rallies from here could be sort of short-lived, even if the dollar were to weaken, post the rate hike. That could only come as an opportunity to sell metals again, because the U.S.-China potential trade war tensions, is something which is really going to affect the markets for some time, because the markets will be closely watching that particular thing, and that sentiment really, keeping away all the bulls from the base metal market overall. So I think it's a sell on any uptick as of now, but there's a possibility of some kind of a retracement post the FOMC. One can position themselves on the long side only if there is that kind of a bottomish sign, and if the FOMC clearly indicates a possibility of dollar weakening.
Okay, all right, Manisha as well as Gyaneshikar, we're going to leave it on that note. Thanks very much for joining in and taking us through all of those commodity strategies. Just want to point out what's happening with a couple of stocks. Shilpa Medicare, for example, is now at the high point of the day. That stock is up around 12.5%. Strong volumes being generated on that counter. And separately, something like a JBF Industries is now showing an 18% cut. Don't know what whether there's any sort of particular news piece on that, but do watch out for that stock, now down around 19% for that particular counter. Nothing much to incrementally talk about in terms of the markets, except for the fact that it's weak and we're just about testing our 200-day moving average. Let's see whether we manage to sustain above that or close above that. But like you can see, we've slipped below that level of 10,161 or thereabout, which is the 200-day moving average. But on to some important market opinion then. In an exclusive conversation with Shireen Bhan at the Rising India Summit, Ruchi Sharma, the head of emerging markets at Morgan Stanley Investment Management, says investors are waiting for India to become the next China and that there are still enough opportunities here.
My thing is that this country is forever rising, you know, whatever you want to sort of make out of it, right? So that it's on a continuous sort of upward march, but it's a sort of chaotic march. Mm. And for every sort of positive story, there's a negative story. You have these incredibly good Indian companies that have given a lot of value back to investors, and they're very high quality in terms of if you look at the metrics like return on equity, consistent earnings growth. India ranks right up there, mm-hmm. compared to any nation in the world, if you take it as a share of the total companies listed out here, which is quite large. So it's a country that we always want to be engaged with.
Sure.
But obviously, we keep looking at the fact that what more could be done for India to have, you know, become like the next China?
Is it harder to find value in India today, given where prices are, given where valuations are?
You know, the biggest cliche in the world I find is that the easy money has already been made, right? Because you look back at the past and you find that it's been done. So I don't think that, you know, like, there's always going to be opportunity out here. Yes, the fact is that a lot of optimism had crept in, and some of that optimism is getting deflated very quickly. Mm. But I don't think that this is ever going to be a market which is going to sort of, like, just tank and you know, no,
do you see
enough opportunities. I don't think that we are sort of sufficiently engaged. We see enough opportunity. There are enough high quality companies available out here.
Okay, you can catch the entire interview with Ruchi Sharma, head of emerging markets, Morgan Stanley Investment Management, later at 6 p.m. in the evening, only on CNBC TV 18. I mean, so that's an interesting conversation. The full thing later. 41 points lower on the Nifty now. It'll come up on your screen. 10,154 is where we are at. So we are now cracking up a little bit more. We are basically at the day's lowest point. You can also quickly look at the advanced decline. Because 1650 stocks lower as compared to what, 400 stocks higher. So that's looking pretty poor now on the NSE. Same's the case with the BSE. And, you know, the mid-cap index is losing even more ground, almost 1.5% lower, 266 odd points in the red. The Nifty Bank is also down about 0.4%. I mean, it's losing in line with what the larger indices are doing.
It's at again, this financials point in time. Really, you'd have to say, you know, the likes of OBC, which is down around 4%. We have REC, which is down around 4%. Again, PFC, which is at a fresh 52-week low. So you can see that the kind of stress that we're seeing, and maybe it has something to do with what's happening politically as well, which seems to be weighing in terms of what's happening with the markets.